Hello everyone, and welcome back to Arts History. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at the sometimes difficult task of setting up World War II web gear based on primary source documents. Alright, so during World War II, the U.S. Army issued a manual to soldiers called the Basic Field Manual, or the Soldier's Handbook. In this book, diagrams are provided of the proper way to set up the web gear. Alright, so the regulation pistol belt. The main belt is going to be the M1936 pistol belt, and starting from left to right, here we go. We have the magazine pouch, the canteen pouch, the first aid pouch, and the holster with the 1911 pistol. In the manual, the gear is going to be a little bit earlier war, since the manual was actually published in 1941. So we're not really going to worry about the variation of the gear. We're trying to focus on the placement specifically, but that's something that you'll have to note. The pistol belt setup would have been worn by officers, and when the M1 carbine came into production, the magazine pouch for the M1 carbine would have been worn on this belt as well. Specialized professions such as truck drivers or rear line support units would have worn belts like this also. Again, this is regulation setup. So the next web gear setup that the manual depicts is the cartridge belt, which would have been worn by your average enlisted soldier. This one's pretty simple. You have the cartridge belt, and on the left rear, you're going to have the canteen pouch, and on the rear right, you're going to have the first aid pouch. The next setup we have here is just a configuration of the cartridge belt setup. You still have the canteen pouch and the first aid pouch, but you also have the suspenders and the haversack, which would have been used to carry the soldier's personal items and blanket, shelter half, and trenching tool and bayonet. So a special note on the bayonet. So when the bayonet is in use, it'll be carried on the left side of the haversack, but when the haversack's not in use and the bayonet is still in use, it is carried on the left hip of the cartridge belt. Now that we've talked about the regulation setup, we're going to take a look at the reality of combat a bit. The manual was written in 1941 and the nation was not yet at war. Yes, the manual was based on information gathered during World War I, but World War II presented a whole new environment, or I should say environments. Once America started to get boots on the ground in different regions of the world, the web gear doctrine shifted and different items were dropped or added to the kit depending on the soldier's preference. Often, gear that was found too cumbersome or heavy was either left out completely or modded to make it more comfortable for the soldier. Gear setups also could have been changed based on the nature of fighting in a certain region. For example, soldiers of the 2nd Armored Division rarely wore haversacks because when they were in Normandy, they would attach the haversacks to the sides of half-tracks, which were promptly ripped to shreds by the hedgerows. These are things that need to be observed based on unit, location, and time frame. What we'll do now is take a look at a variety of photos from different locations and eras during the war that show the varying web gear setups, and then set up our web gear based on what we observe. In this photo from 1943 showing two soldiers in training conducting field maneuvers, you can see the use of suspenders and a haversack on the M36 pistol belt. You'll notice that the first aid pouch and the canteen pouch are actually swapped as opposed to the regulation setup. Laid out, the setup would look like this. Compared to the regulations, the pistol and magazine pouch were removed, and the canteen pouch and the first aid pouch swap places. And the obvious one is the addition of the haversack and the M36 suspenders, though this actually was in the manual and was something that was often done by officers or M1 carbine users. Also note the earlier war metal cap canteen. If you want more information on canteen, check out my first video ever on this channel, which I'll link in the description. Next up, we have this photo depicting a 2nd Armored Division armored car moving through the streets of a French town. The soldier is wearing the M36 belt with the pouch for the M1 carbine magazines on the immediate left, first aid pouch on his front right, and what looks to be the shadow of the canteen pouch on his rear right. He is also wearing a pair of M3 binoculars around his neck. Laid out, his gear would look like this. Here the soldier replaces his 1911 pouch with an M1 carbine pouch, and he moves his canteen to the rear of the opposite side. This film still is of an infantryman from the 29th Infantry Division crossing the Roar River on a footbridge. He's wearing the cartridge belt as he is carrying an M1 Garand. He wears the suspenders and haversack as well as a first aid pouch on his right hip. On his left hip, he wears an M43 entrenching tool, and on his back left, he wears a canteen. The soldier also carries a bandolier of extra ammunition under his right shoulder. Laid out, his gear would look like this. Actually, this setup is pretty close to the regulation setup, with the addition of the bandolier and the movement of the shovel from the haversack to the left of the canteen on the cartridge belt. In this photo showing men from the 41st Armored Infantry Regiment, 2nd Armored Division, the soldier wears his entrenching tool on his left hip and his canteen to the back right. I also think it's a fair assumption that the soldier was most likely carrying a first aid pouch behind his entrenching tool. It doesn't appear that he was wearing suspenders, though he does have a bandolier draped under his left side. His camouflage is a short-lived Normandy pattern only issued in small numbers that was phased out because of friendly fire incidents. Laid out, his gear would look like this. In comparison to the regulations, this soldier has swapped his first aid pouch and canteen pouch, and since he doesn't have a haversack, he places his shovel to the left of his first aid pouch. One last one. This is a still from footage showing a soldier of the 29th Infantry Division retrieving water somewhere in France. He wears a cartridge belt with no suspenders, with a first aid pouch on his back right. He wears an empty shovel cover on his left hip because a SWAT had been digging foxholes earlier in the footage, and he left his shovel with his unit. He also wears a canteen on his back left. His gear would look like this. This soldier's setup differs from the regulations because his first aid and canteen pouches have SWAT places, and since he doesn't have a haversack, he wears his shovel next to his canteen pouch on the right side.
Well, that about wraps it up. In conclusion, the web gear that a soldier wore while in combat really depended on the situation they encountered in the field. Personal preference and loadouts based on environment ended up really replacing the regulations that were in place that were developed pre-war. The best way to get an accurate setup is through specific unit research and photo analysis.
Thanks so much for watching, everyone. If you want to see some more military-related content, check out my other videos. If you want to see something in particular reviewed in a video, leave a like and a comment. And I'll see you guys next time.